China, prepare for a big rise in bad loans. Chinese Banking Regulatory Authority warns. Last week, Chinese financial regulators took over 9 financial institutions that were on the verge of collapse. These included 4 insurers, 2 trust firms, and 3 securities firms. As per a report by Wall Street Journal, these financial institutions managed a combined asset of 1 trillion yuan or $143 billion. And the market failures of these can trigger a financial crisis. The Banking and Insurance Regulatory Commission, China's apex authority for regulation of banking and insurance sector, has warned the government to prepare for a big rise in bad loans as the financial system copes with coronavirus and increasing sanctions against Chinese companies imposed by countries around the world. Although Chinese authorities have tried to paint a rosy picture of the Chinese economy by fudging statistics and claiming a miraculous rebound in GDP growth rate, the financial system is cracking at the grassroots level thanks to reckless lending by non-banking financial institutions in the last decade. A statement summarizing a working conference held by China's banking regulator this week said China has to prevent the coal ash of shadow banking from burning again, while avoiding a resurgence of chaos in real estate financing. The statement further added that it has to make full preparations to counter changes in the external environment over the long run. Amid the unprecedented economic contraction and boycott of Chinese goods around the world, China is now witnessing an increasing number of bank runs. In the last few weeks, local banks in 2 Chinese provinces, Hebei and Shaanxi, have been unable to pay back customers even as large number of people gather to withdraw their deposits. The non-performing assets or NPAs of China's local banks have grown exponentially in the last few years as the artificial real estate boom went bust and several companies defaulted on loans. The distrust in the Chinese financial system grew after the coronavirus pandemic, which led to the closing down of many businesses. The increasing momentum of boycott calls against Chinese goods in countries like India, Australia, and the United States has added fuel to the fire. These nations constitute some of the largest markets for Chinese companies. The aggression of the Chinese Communist Party in the Himalayas and the South China Sea has imposed heavy costs on Chinese companies, which are dependent on exports. Last year, the central government of China was forced to take control of local lenders in many provinces to sustain operations. The central government took over Baoshan Bank, a big lender in the province of Inner Mongolia, after it failed to pay back depositors. Beijing also bailed out Bank of Jinzhou and Hengfeng Bank. Recently, a gold scam worth billions of dollars was reported in China. King Gold Jewelry Inc., China's largest privately owned gold processing and jewelry company headquartered in Wuhan, took a loan of more than 20 billion yuan, that is $2.8 billion, with Pure Gold as collateral. But when the shadow banks claimed the gold after the company was unable to pay back, they found that what the company claimed as pure gold was actually copper. Apart from local banks, shadow banks, which are a $3 trillion industry in China, have also started to collapse. A few weeks ago, Sichuan Trust, one of China's largest shadow banks, apologized to investors for missing the deadline for payments on financial products. The statement published on the company's website reads, "Affected by the global economic downturn, the new coronavirus outbreak and the suspension of the issuance of trust products, some companies are unable to return funds on time. As a result, payments have not been distributed on time. Sichuan Trust apologizes to you sincerely." The Chinese companies have lost the market worth trillions of dollars due to the coronavirus pandemic-induced lockdowns and the rising anti-China sentiment in the last few months. This means that these businesses would be unable to pay back and therefore prone to default, which will fuel distrust in banks, leading to the panic withdrawal of deposits. Therefore, the Chinese economy is set to suffer a big jolt in the next few days, shockwaves of which would be felt around the world. As we have said before, China's counterfeit culture and forced demand creation are to be blamed.